Hey there, partner.
Had to buy myself a Derringer for walking about. Seems you can never be too careful anymore.
Despair.
Hello.
Just what exactly are we doing alive? It's a mystery to me. No mistake. Have you got any ideas, big man?
No, not really.
Well, at least you're honest. All my life, I've been surrounded by morons claiming to know the answer to that question. Liars. Bloody lot. Narcissi, all of them. It's the great American sickness, vanity. I'm very drunk.
Monsieur?
I had a man come in here the other day tell me about that.
Time to go, boy.
Look, Nina, you don't need that mask here.
Got something to hide.
Why are you acting like...
Show me your face.
Hello.
Giddy up!
Be with you momentarily.
Morning.
Thanks for your assistance.
Come on.
You leave something behind? Costing you a pretty penny to repay your debt.
Thanks.
Ride the stage. I'll give you a good price.
Have a nice morning.
Good morning.
Thank you.
morning, partner.
How you been doing?
Hey there, friend. How can I help you? Okay, then. Pretty standard fare these days.
Hello again, mister. Did you see those fireworks from the mayor's party? Can't imagine we'll ever get an invitation to that. Change your mind. Sure, I'll take a look. Okay, then. Yeah, I'll take it. They sell. I'll take it.
Thanks for your help. Thanks, partner.
Morning.
You ain't scaring nobody.
Got killed.
Hi there.
Howdy, mister.
Howdy, partner.
Okay, then.
Something to say to me?
stress, boy.
Welcome. Please, take a seat. Only a trim or something fancy-like? Okay, then, let's get you in the chair. Stylish and clean.
So you're getting along okay?
Just sick of it all.
Ah, suits you. Just name your style. All right, you're ready to go.
Don't wash it for a day.
Boy.
Catching my breath.
Watch out.
Oh, you're still behind me?
Hello, sir.
Hey, folks.
Hello.
Well, hey.
Oh, the wind.
Dear boy.
Yes, here I am.
Well, we're going to need to get you smartened up a bit.
Why?
Well, you can't play at the tables on a Lanahassee riverboat looking like this.
Can't?
Not if you want to fit in so well that no one will realize you're there to rob the place. Now, come on.
Are we still doing that?
Of course. We're going to fix you up so fine no one will notice a thing.
Hello, can I help you, gentlemen?
Yes, my friend here is in need of a new suit. We are playing on the riverboat this evening.
Excellent. Well, you'll find all my inventory in the catalog here.
Make this gentleman look like the Duke he really is. It was the English's fault his grandfather had to emigrate. A bitter and jealous people. You can see the aristocrat in his profile. the heavy brow from all the inbreeding.
Might I suggest the fine three-piece town suit, sir? Perfect for the occasion, I'd say. A very good choice, sir.
Come on, let's get you to the barber.
Sure.
Good luck tonight, gentlemen.
Herr Strauss has scoped the whole thing out. It's quite ingenious, actually.
What is?
The action he has planned. Indeed, it's not much of an action at all. You play cards and win. And you're going to bet very big and flamboyantly while you win. And everyone's going to think you're some new money from the oil fields come to lay it on thick and drunk. All the while, Herr Strauss will be signaling you in your line of sight. When you bust the place, they'll take you upstairs to pay you off. And that is when Javier comes in, and you take whatever you want.
You don't think they might see an armed Mexican coming into the safe with me?
Sure, they might, but perhaps not. You will see.
The suspense is killing me.
Oh, don't be so jaded. We both know this is just the kind of innocent fun you thrive on.
Well, after the past couple of months, armed robbery don't seem such an innocent pastime.
No, but we, you, all of us, will be done here soon.
I hope so.
Come on. My good man, could you smarten up my dear hick friend here? This unlikely fellow has made himself a fortune in the oil fields and learned himself not a lick of manners or gentlemanly deportment.
Well, very good, sir.
No, it's not good. Not good at all. Not if they're going to let him play big at the tables tonight. Make him look like a prince, sir.
There, very smart.
Come on, let's get to the docks. I've arranged some transportation for us.
Successful evening, gentlemen.
How do you do?
Hop on and let's go, my boy. Keeping a gentleman waiting. I don't know. George! To the Grand Corrigan, please.
Grand Corrigan, sir.
Well, look at you! From Toad to Prince.
This is a bit much, ain't it? The coach?
We can't whinny up there on horses like a bunch of countrified yokels. You're a brash oil man. Money to burn. Which reminds me, no shuffling and mumbling. Puff your chest out. Get outside yourself.
Yeah, all right, all right. Saint Hammond. So, who's a mark?
Are you all right, by the way, driver?
Oh, yes. Don't worry. George and I go way back. It's a man called Desmond Blythe. Made a fortune in hosiery, of all things. Likes to play fast and always keep some extra collateral in the safe upstairs.
So, if Strauss is sitting behind him, how does he know what cards I got?
He won't.
but the dealer has recently become a very good friend of mine.
Another one.
Don't worry, Arthur. We're all the authors of our own good fortune. He'll make sure you get the right cards.
What could possibly go wrong?
Indeed. She is. Come on.
Okay.
Arthur, leave any weaponry here. There are searches when we get on. George, we'll collect these from you later.
Very good, sir.
Thank you, George.
Good luck, sir.
Now remember what I said, Arthur. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Yes. Yes. Believe me, I heard every word.
Watch Strauss. Listen to the dealer, and this should be a very lucky night. There they are.
Gentlemen, how wonderful to see you. Arthur, you remember this pair of boys we met in New York?
Come on.
Champagne is on dear old Arthur. He's rich as can be and feeling luckier than a turkey that survived Thanksgiving.
Hello, gentlemen.
Hello, dear boy. Come on, come on, let's head aboard. Drinks on Arthur. Champagne.
How is everything with you?
I'm afraid we require all patrons to hand over their guns.
Good time. The tables await.
I'll go find myself a change of clothes.
Okay.
You seem unsure.
Robbing a heavily armed riverboat without a gun tends to bring out the self-doubt in me.
These people are virtually idiots. This is simple stuff. Now have a good time, but don't lose too much money or your wife is going to kill me.
Whatever you say.
Now where can I get a cocktail?
Looks like there's still an open seat, sir.
Hey, mister.
Hello.
How do you do?
Welcome aboard, sir.
We have a chair here with your name on it, sir.
Good evening, gentlemen. Arthur Callahan. Sorry, I'm late. I had some unfinished business at the bar.
Evening. Desmond Blythe.
Evening.
Not to worry. Welcome to the game, Mr. Callahan. Okay, gentlemen, let's play.
I hope you're a player. Been too many cowards at these tables recently. Nothing less dignified than a man afraid to lose a little money.
Look at this! Chips already stacked up, waiting for me. I like this joint already.
We aim to please, sir.
So, how are we all faring?
Some better than others.
If we all fared the same in life now, where would the fun be?
Quiet.
Wait, not Desmond Blythe, the hosiery king. I should have brought my other wallet.
Not my preferred title, but yes, you should have. Okay, sorry, boys. I'm taking it all.
We'll see about that.
To hell with it. Here we go, then.
Well, hello, my ladies.
Mr. Blythe wins with three queens.
Goodbye, gentlemen. I guess it's just you and me now, friend.
Yes, it is.
Time to see if you're really the man you seem to think you are.
Likewise, Mr. Blythe.
So, what business are you in, Mr. Callahan?
I'm an oil man, for my sins.
Funny, I haven't heard of you.
Oh, you will. You know, I thought about getting into hosiery, but I just look better in a suit.
I would stick to oil, Mr. Callahan. I don't think you have a future on the stage.
You sound just like my wife.
Raise.
Call. Okay, Mr. Callahan, I'm all in.
Whenever you're ready, sir.
Call.
Interesting.
Pair of cowgirls.
Ship. Ship.
I guess my luck held. Is that you done?
Done.
Bust. Or, you got something else to play with.
Meaning?
Well, I heard there was some big boys on this boat. Maybe that's not you. No offense.
Sit your hillbilly ass down.
Why?
I got a watch.
Look at you.
An expensive one. Real fine. Swiss. A Reutlinger, no less. It's in the safe upstairs. It's worth more than you.
Okay. I trust you.
Now play.
As you wish.
So, you must know Leviticus Cornwall, big oil man like you.
Of course, we've crossed paths. I was fortunate enough to tour a little operation of his up in New Hanover.
Let's not waste any more time here. All in.
Don't worry, sir. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune. Your action, Mr. Callahan.
Well, nothing ventured, nothing gained. Pair of kings.
Very good, but not good enough.
Shit. Uh-oh. Yes, you little beauty.
Hard lines, Mr. Blythe. Mr. Callahan wins with an ace-high diamond flush.
God damn you! No offense.
None taken.
Well played, sir.
Unlucky, Desmond.
Now, forgive my lack of discretion, but, where might I find this watch?
It's upstairs. Shall we go and have a look?
Why not?
Gentlemen.
Please, cash these out for me.
I started last week.
Good. Sure. Perhaps you could escort us up to the office.
Yes, of course, sir.
Thank you.
Follow me, gentlemen.
Come with me, sir. You're having quite the night.
Yeah, so far.
I cannot believe someone gave a greaser a job.
We live in strange times.
Personally, I wouldn't trust one with a gun, but fear not. I've got my own little lawgiver right here.
Very good.
Next, we'll be hiring Negroes.
I know.
I think you're going to like this watch, sir. I saw it earlier, and it really is a handsome piece. Foreign made, but you can't have everything.
Indeed.
Well, here we are. Just give me 1 second, sir.
Of course, take your time. Don't reach for that gun.
Take his gun, Arthur. Come on, what are you doing?
I guess you were right. Only an idiot would give a greaser a gun.
Idiot, huh?
no one heard that. Quick, clear the safe. Let's get out of here.
Can't believe that asshole had another gun.
The view in here is looking pretty good.
How much is there?
Must be a few thousand plus the watch.
Nice. Now let's get out of here. Come on. Let's go meet the others.
Sure.
I reckon we've only got a few minutes to get out of here.
If we're lucky.
Was that a gunshot?
It sounded like one. Come on.
And how exactly are we getting out of here?
I ain't too sure. This is what tends to happen when you leave Trelawney in charge of planning. Oh, garnish no meat. Probably involve us dressing up as dancing girls and can-canning off the side. Nice uniform, by the way.
Thanks. I'd give anyone a job these days. Anyway, we shouldn't give ourselves away till we know we need to. Maybe we could still blend into the crowd when it all goes crazy.
Which it surely will. To the bar, senor!
I hope you had fun, sir.
The time of my life. You boys sure know how to put on a show.
That's wonderful. Ah, look, there's your friend.
No, sir, my friend is not a no-good cheat, and I beg you to take back the insinuation.
There he is.
Now, don't be a sore loser, friend.
There's something I don't like about the pair of you.
There's plenty I don't like about you, but I have the good manners to keep my mouth shut.
There he is. Shoot that man.
I don't know. This ain't my show. Silly me. I clean forgot to bring my gun to...
Arthur, come on.
We need to get out of here.
How do you suggest?
I don't know. This ain't my show. Silly me. I clean forgot to bring my gondola.
Damn it. We gotta go. Come on. What's up with this? Death is right next to me.
Never a dull moment.
Yeah, that's one way of putting it.
So, how much did we get?
A few thousand, I think. Pretty good.
Yes, indeed.
And this watch. Apparently it's worth a bunch. Swiss, a Reutlinger or something?
Nice watch. Yes, it's a Reutlinger, all right.
We'll give it back then. All right, come on, let's get out of here.
Riverboat Rob!
There, boy. How are you, boy?
Mister?
Hola.
Hey, partner. Hey, mister.
Hey there, mister.
This goddamn government is a lie.
Easy there. Come here.
Are you ready for Tahiti, Mr. Pearson?
Tahiti,
sure. Tahiti.
speak 7 languages.
Okay.
Oh, how'd it go in town?
With Abigail, anything is possible. Best actress I ever saw.
Really?
Oh, sure. She had half the town believing we were real estate investors from New England. Everybody is following her. This after she placed a little explosive device. When we go back, there'll be an almighty bang.
So you think this bank job's gonna work?
Get everything packed. We're leaving.
I hope so. I really do. This place is not for me.
I'm glad you've done the planning for this one. Not like, well, you know.
No mistakes. I'm ready for my retirement.
You okay?
Hello, Mr. Morgan.
Don't you ever get fed up with all this?
Sometimes, I suppose.
Hey, Arthur.
There he is. That scar healed pretty well in the end.
I'm stuck with him now.
Hey, Mary Beth.
Well, look at that fancy haircut, Mr. Morgan. Who are you trying to
impress? It was good working with you, Mr. Strauss.
Yes, well, I suppose it worked out in the end.
Yeah, we did good. Marston?
Arthur.
Hi, Charles.
Hey, Arthur.
Hardest worker in camp.
Someone's got to do it.
Little Johnny Marston.
Did you think that up all by yourself?
So very popular with the ladies.
What's your damn problem with me?
I'm only kidding around.
You're a strange man, Morgan.
Hey.
Hello, Arthur.
You okay?
I'm bored.
Oh, hi, Arthur.
Ladies? You all right, Molly?
Bored?
Well, there's plenty of work needs doing.
Okay. Hey there.
Thanks for all your efforts.
You're very welcome.
If only you weren't such a miserable crone.
Who do you think you're talking to?
I'm only joking with you.
It wasn't funny 10 years ago, and it still isn't now.
How you doing, Abigail?
My, I do like this new haircut of yours.
Blame Trelawney. Okay, well, let's talk more later.
Okay.
Thank you.